The inner machinations of my mind are an enigma.
Hello YouTube's Krosama, and here I have the Build Strike Galaxy Cosmos, and today, or I guess for me tonight, we're going to go ahead and put it into as good of poses as we can. To be honest, this is not really going to turn out too well, just due to the fact that the backpack isn't really, it doesn't really connect well when it comes to dynamic poses. It's kind of just there. It's not like how maybe the double riser, you can kind of fix the binders in some, you know, pretty cool ways. Or maybe like the Strike Freedom, you can kind of like move them around. But these, it's just going to be there. I mean, you can kind of twist them a little bit, but for the most part, they're not going to be as dynamic as maybe some other mobile suits that have big backpacks or wings or something of the sort. So without further ado, since I already have it with his backpack on, that's actually going to be the first pose we're going to go ahead and start doing, is a pose with it with his backpack on, and it's, you know, Patrick Starfish mode. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get right into it. Okay, and here's the pose I went ahead and just kind of rolled with. Pretty much him, you know, plugging in that shield because he probably absorbed a couple of, you know, bits of energy. So that way he can go ahead and unleash a pretty big, you know, plasma blast or whatever it's going to be called, beam blast. I just kind of figure he's getting pushed back a little bit by the immense power and just the kickback of the actual blast itself. So I'm just kind of imagining that's the position that he would actually take when, you know, shooting off his, you know, beam rifle. So I think it looks okay. More likely this would be the pose that I would want him in, but to be honest, I don't really want to sacrifice a stand for this kit. I'd rather just have this kit standing up on the shelf. I can use the stand for maybe another kit that probably is more deserving of an aerial pose than this one. But overall, like, it doesn't really look too bad. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get into the second pose. Okay, and this is the second pose. Nothing really too spectacular. I really was thinking, like, how am I going to go ahead and have it with that, I guess the galaxy mode or the star mode? I really didn't know. I was just thinking, like, him having the shield sucks. Because bringing those little, like, these little parts right here down, they don't go all the way down with that shield in a way, and it's really hard to maneuver it in order so that way it can really come down far enough, you know, to at least look good or to be symmetrical with the right side. So I was like, you know what, let me just scrap the gun and the shield and just pull out both beam sabers. I was thinking about doing like a dashing one, but you know what, I kind of want it to be upright so that way you can see all the little wings spanned out and you can see it in its full form, because I think if you're hiding it by tilting it and it's like you can't really see it that well, I think overall it's going to take away from the aesthetic of it being in this kind of like, you know, ultra mode. So I don't think it's that great. It looks okay, but it's not really like an amazing pose. So you can definitely pull off something a little bit better by maybe dashing or doing something with the gun without the shield maybe. But to me, this is like one of the better poses I could have pulled off with the wings and everything all open. So let's go ahead and get into the third and final pose. We'll be right back. All right, and here is the final pose. I do remember him. I think it was the first episode when he fought the Gion. I'm pretty sure it's the first episode, or it was at least one episode in Build Fighters where he didn't have the backpack. He didn't have any backpack, and for his Build Strike, he didn't even have a gun. He had a gun, and I think it got destroyed. I don't think he built the shield, and he had his beam sabers. So he just went ahead and rushed in, and I remember he slashed the Gion. And that was just a pretty awesome moment. I was really impressed that even with Sayori being so inexperienced, he still utilized the beam saber to his best abilities. And this kind of shows me, like, this little pose right here is like, hey, without your proper weapons, without the backpack accessory, I mean, what are you gonna have left? Well, you're probably gonna have a damn beam saber. If not a beam saber, then you're gonna have some kind of plot hole device, maybe a leftover weapon on the ground, or some kind of plot hole something going on. But I think for the most part, your beam saber is always going to be your most reliable weapon when kind of pinned against the wall. So that's the reason I chose this. It was just a pretty iconic looking pose. Once again, not something I'm going to pose him with. I'm probably just going to have him standing up completely normal with the backpack and all the wings open. And that's pretty much it. So that's My overall impression as far as the poses for this is going to be hard. It's going to be very, very difficult. But if you can make something amazing, then definitely go for it. But me personally, like, I do like the base mobile suit. I don't like the backpack. And it's just something that I'm going to have to figure out a little bit later once I actually get all my stuff in, how I'm going to pose it. But like I said, it's probably just going to be standing normally with its weapons, and I don't think I'm ever really going to touch this again. But I do hope that some of these poses may have given you some inspiration. If not, then hey, keep on working towards trying to figure out whatever poses that you need. And if you do have this kit, hopefully one of these poses is going to be pretty nice for you to actually go ahead and pose this particular kit in. But that's it, guys. Definitely thanks for watching. Pretty much gonna get ready for that next review, which should be Thursday. It's gonna be on the Gundam FSD, so get ready for that one. And as always, guys, definitely like, comment, and subscribe, especially if you haven't. And ring that bell for notifications, that way you always stay up to date with any kind of future pose videos, as well as future reviews I make in the future. So that's it for me, guys. I'll see y'all tomorrow. Bye-bye.